discuss our regular meeting. First step on the agenda is approve the minutes from February 1st. Second, any questions, comments, changes?
I have this one on page five. Midway down, it's two paragraphs above our objectives. Just a correction, the donation was for $300.
All those in favor of approving the minutes as amended? Unanimous? Time for some comments. I'm saying that usually we don't need to use microphones up here, but if anyone's having a hard time hearing or it's hard to hear, I'm sorry. So
are there any sense of movements at this point?
There's a microphone.
Yeah, there's a microphone.
I have discussed this with many people all over the country, and the discussion needs to continue here in our school. Our schools here in New Hampshire are very safe. I would not be here if our schools were not the most safest schools in America. School safety is the most important thing to me as a parent. This child attends Jackson Brown School. I trust our teachers, administrators, staff, and the principal. However, the police are not infallible. And gun control laws are also not recalled. It would take minutes for the police to get to a situation where seconds count. We have a hardened state thanks to the preservation of our gun rights, and we need to follow this hardened strategy within our schools to make them also a hardened target. I would suggest having one or more staff members or a teacher, whoever would be, you know, the appropriate person to have a concealed carry in the event of an emergency. And this is the most powerful and proven deterrent, along with signage that lets intruders know that our school is armed and trained. This makes everyone, parents, children, and school members all safe.
Yeah. The only thing I have is an executive board meeting next Thursday night, 6:00 PM.
Yes, I have just a couple of things. I've done a survey with our sixth graders about to their experiences, how they participated in student conferences and what they thought were available, how much their education feels like it's tailored to their strengths and weaknesses. And then I've asked them about one thing that people could definitely at school that would have enhanced their experience here. I paraphrased what they said, we did this in focus groups, and did it in kind of a discussion format, but found it quite interesting. So I've just summarized their responses for you, and we'll look at since both the personalization and the student-led conferences were new to us this year. And then the other piece was, we had our first issue of the Newsletter published, our first school newspaper. Was done at the after-school program. It's a fairly interesting article, editorial in there. Molly Delavalla and Autumn, who I saw Autumn here somewhere. Where are you, Autumn? My two editors. The sixth graders acted as editors and assisted the younger students with their revisions and editing of their stories. So I think maybe reach a copy so you can take a look at what they did. Here's a really good group of people.
I have one question in reference to the focus group of the sixth grade. Did you, the student-led conferences were they made, what grade did they attend?
We've done 4, 5, and 6. However, I only asked the sixth grade.
And is there still time to have one-on-one without the students?
Absolutely. Yes. Just the students really enjoyed being able to talk about their work and their individual challenges as well as their strengths. They felt really good about sharing that work with their parents and knowing what they had to work on. They did ask about things like setting goals for themselves and having more opportunities for independent projects and work to suit their particular creativity needs and talents. They were very thoughtful, very mature, and healthy.
That brings us back to
citizens.
Thank you.